Nobody likes ads, and in this video we are going to be blocking them. And no, I'm not talking about your typical web browser ad blocker. You can see I have mine paused right here because I don't need it anymore. I'm talking about something like AdGuard here. This is a DNS server that you hook up and it will filter out IP addresses and domain names associated with advertisements. So you'll basically be going from something like this to this. Pretty nice. Another alternative to this is a very popular application called Pi-hole, and I do have a separate video on that that also is a Proxmox installation. So if you're interested in checking out the differences and whatnot, you could check out that video as well. They're both great. They both work good. Both open source applications. You can see here I set it up yesterday. We already have 34,000 DNS queries, and of those, 2,800 of them have been blocked. You get a lot of information here, including some general statistics, your top clients, which lists the IP addresses. And you can see there's a lot. This is network-wide, so all the clients within my home network are going to be using this. And then down here, we have the top query domains. We have the top block domains, which gives you some information on what they are and what they do. We have information on the upstreams as well as the average response time for those upstreams. And then we have some other settings and stuff, which we will go into after the installation. Again, this is a Proxmox installation, and with helper scripts, this is going to be incredibly easy. You can see right here, this is my current AdGuard instance, and we are just going to spin up another one and go through the process here. If you don't know what Proxmox is and you don't have it installed, there's two videos that I made that I'd recommend. One is the best server or home server operating systems, and I have another one going over the installation process. Installing Proxmox is as simple as any other Linux distribution. And speaking of helper scripts, we are using the helper scripts. This makes it so painfully easy. They have a bunch of different ones too, so if you want to go ahead and explore, you can. And in my own Proxmox instance, you could see I have Home Assistant OS, Plex, and MB all using these helper scripts. And if we go back over here, you could see all the categories of everything they got. So media, photo, lots of different things. They have NVR, DVRs, dashboards, just a whole lot of everything that you'll need. But we are going to be focusing on AdBlocker DNS, and AdGuard Home is right here. Do note that it's always important when you run scripts or anything that is automated, it's important to know what you're actually running. Good thing if you go ahead and view on GitHub here, they actually have all the scripts here. So if we go to install, you can see all the different SH files to all the different things they offer. So for example, if we go to the MB install SH file, you can see the actual script that's going to run, everything that it's going to do, all the permissions it's going to set, everything it's going to install, where it's pulling the applications from, and more. So it's always good to give that a quick scan before you go ahead and install anything. So back to the helper scripts here, we are going to go with AdGuard. Again, there's Pi-hole and some other options, but in this one, we're going to go with Pi-hole. And this is going to install it as a container. Containers versus virtual machines on Proxmox use considerably less system resources because they utilize the same kernel and whatnot. And we can see the default settings here. I'll show you how you can change the default settings. Gives you a brief overview of exactly what it is, what it does. So let's go ahead and copy this bash script here and head over to Proxmox. So what you're going to want to do is go to the instance in which you want to have it installed on, head over to the shell, and we are simply going to paste in this command. Go ahead and hit enter. When you do that, you'll see this right here. This will create a new AdGuard XLC. Would you like to proceed? Now here, the default settings for most people are going to be perfect. I will have them right here if you're interested in checking those out. So if this works good for you, you can just hit yes and continue. For me, I'm going to go advanced because I do want to give it just a little bit more system resources. Use the spacebar to select things, continue. We are going to be using Debian 12, so let's go ahead and keep that selected. Tab down to OK. And let's use the latest version of Debian Bookworm, and then continue. We're going to have this as an unprivileged container. You could read about that a little more if you'd like to. I'll leave some links in the description. Continue. And then we have our root password here. This is for SSH access. So go ahead and type in something here that's moderately strong and secure. Continue. We're going to set our container ID. You can put whatever you want as long as it's not taken. 104 is going to be fine for me. Hostname AdGuard is fine. This is a temporary instance, so I'm just going to call this AdGuard-new. And then from there, let's continue. Now, the disk size in gigabytes. AdGuard really doesn't take up a whole lot of room. And you can see here after logging, after 90 days of statistics, it only takes up 2 megabytes. 7 days of query logs is 53 megabytes. So really not a whole lot of space. Regardless, 2 is pretty small. I have a lot of room on here. I don't want to have to ever really think about it again. So let's go ahead and go with 4. So continue from there. CPU cores, I'm gonna give it 2, just so it's a little bit more powerful. And 1 is completely fine, but let's go ahead and continue. Now RAM in the system. Now I can actually reference my existing container here really quick. So if I go over here to AdGuard, summary, let's see what it's using right now. So it's using 35 megabytes of RAM and like none of the CPU. There's not a lot of clients on it right now, but even then it's very, very low, hardly uses any system resources at all. So realistically, the 512 megabytes of RAM is going to be completely fine. Let's continue. You probably could even go a little less. And then select the bridge. The default, in most cases, is what you're going to want. Unless if you really know your Proxmox instance and you have multiple networks on it, then you might want to change this. So continue here. DHCP is going to be fine. Continue. That's going to automatically pull an IP address for it. For this, we're going to leave it blank to keep the default. I don't use IPv6 on my network, but I'm also not going to disable it just in case if that changes in the future. MTU size, let's do default. For the DNS search domain, let's leave that as our host. And for the IP, let's also leave that blank for now to leave it as host, as well as the MAC address. Let's let it pull its own. Set a VLAN, default, enable root SSH access. For this, we gave it a password, but I'm gonna keep this disabled because I could just access it through Proxmox directly. It's only gonna be running the single service, so I don't necessarily have a reason to SSH into it. And then last but not least, we are not going to be enabling verbose mode. And then let's create the container. So you could see all the settings there that we picked. And then it's gonna run through the process of pulling the, we're actually creating the container, pulling the dependencies, installing the software and applying our settings. And boom, we can see it kind of popped up right there for us. It's using the helper scripts and it's installing AdGuard Home. So now we should be able to access it through here. Let's go ahead and do that. So let's go ahead, give this a copy. I'll go ahead and pop it on this page. And there we go. So welcome to AdGuard Home. First thing first, let's get rid of that light mode, go to dark mode and get started here. So we have our listen interfaces. When in doubt, leave everything here as the default, unless of course you have very specific reasons to change some of the things that you are seeing here. So let's continue. Create our administrator account. Give yourself a pretty good password and we will go next. Here it has a little tutorial on how to configure various devices. You're probably gonna wanna go with the router if you want this to be a network-wide thing, but I'll show you how to get back to that. So let's go ahead and hit next. And then open our dashboard. So let's go ahead and sign in here. Oh, why is it not saving? And it's up and running. We do have some settings here. So let's head over to settings. You have general settings, DNS settings, encryption, client, and DCP settings. I'm gonna leave documentation down below so you can explore a lot of these. But one thing you might want to do is change your DNS server. We could see in my active instance here, the response time of the default one is significantly more than something like Cloudflare's default. So to change it, for example, if you wanted to change it to Cloudflare, you could use whatever you prefer to use. All we would do is go ahead and pop that in here. And then you can scroll down. We have a fallback. So for this, maybe we just use Google's and then we're good to go. So you could test the upstreams. It's working. Apply. There we go. And again, we have more things under like general settings. So you can use their security service, their parental control service. You can set it to use safe search. There's a lot of settings and whatnot that you could go through and actually explore, customize, including encryption settings, various client settings, and more. So from there, if we go back over to the setup guide, we want to actually be able to use this. And there are numerous ways to do this. We have Windows, macOS, Android, iOS, DNS, privacy, as well as router. For example, if I were, it doesn't say Linux here, but I can still show you that regardless. And doing it on your specific device is only gonna have that device accessing this DNS server that you set up, which will not apply it to network-wide coverage, but I'll show you that in a sec right after I connect this computer specifically to it so you can go ahead and test it out and see if it's working for you. So I'm gonna copy the IP address for our AdGuard instance. And no matter what operating system you're on, you're gonna want to head over to your settings and then go under network. If you're using a cable, for my instance, let's go Wi-Fi. Head over to my settings. And then for this, it's under IPv4. and we have DNS. So I'm going to disable automatic. I'm going to paste in this IP address and just the IP address. Apply that setting, close out. If I head over to my dashboard and actually go to a website that is absolutely wretched and ad-ridden, such as CNN.com, there we go. We can see we're having some issues loading up some of these ads, which is a very, very good sign. So now, if we head over to my new instance of AdGuard, and let's go ahead and click this refresh statistics. And there we go. We can see that my only client is the only device that I connected. We have 10 queries, and there's actually nothing blocked at the moment. And that is because I actually set my main AdGuard home server through my router. So this is catching it before this instance can. But on my main instance, if we go over here and go to query log, you can see here that we have a whole bunch of things blocked rather recently from our local instance, which this is the IP address of the computer I'm recording this on. And all of this is that CNN trash. Now going up here to the setup guide and actually using this as your whole network-wide DNS is gonna require you to log into your modem, router, whatever you happen to be using. In my case, I am using Omada and the Omada controller. This is probably gonna look completely different for you. Basically just searching up your router brand, model, and how to set custom DNS. For my instance, I need to go to my home, and then from there go down to settings. Went to my wired network, my LAN, and this is what controls the LAN or the main interface for my network. Give that an edit. And then right down here, you can see DNS server. I switched it from auto to manual, and then I set it to the IP address associated with my main AdGuard instance. And now it filters out all the ads on my network. So that's how you do it. I do recommend you check out those Proxmox helper scripts, especially if you're somebody who runs Proxmox. Makes it really easy to go ahead and spin some stuff up, really save you some time on manual installations for various services. And yeah, again, I'll post links down below to everything that I talked about. I do hope you have an absolutely beautiful day, and goodbye.